Hi children, good morning.
Today we are going to discuss the numerical part of the current electricity chapter. So this is current electricity chapter and this is video number 21. I am going to discuss numericals from the exercise. I have mentioned page number 127 of NCRT part 1.
So page number 127 of NCRT part 1. You open the textbook and just follow. Otherwise also I have written the question on the board so that you can have it as a direct part, right?
So the first numerical is, read the first numerical that is displayed on the board.
The storage battery of a car has an EMF of 12 volt. If the internal resistance of the battery is 0.4 ohm, what is the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery?
They are asking maximum current. Generally, when a battery has an internal resistance, this is the battery and this is the internal resistance, is connected across any circuit capital, then the equation for current becomes E by the total resistance R plus R. Here, it is the storage battery and there is no external resistance connected. Therefore, we have to take this capital R 0. So when capital R is 0, then current will be maximum, but I maximum equal to E by smaller.
I hope it's clear. So the current will be maximum when the external resistance in the circuit becomes 0. So the only resistance that is in the circuit will be internal resistance.
So now for this question, the formula for Imax is equal to EMF of the cell by internal resistance. The EMF of the cell is given to you as 12 volt, 12 by internal resistance is 0.4, 12 by 0.4, it is 120 by 4, it is 30 ampere.
I hope children understood. So the maximum current will be 30 ampere. Go to the second question. In the second question, a battery of EMF, read the question carefully. A battery of EMF and internal resistance 3 ohm.
What is the EMF of the battery? 10 volt. Internal resistance 3 ohm. Is connected to a resistor. If the current in the circuit is 0.5 ampere, they are asking what is the resistance of the resistor and also the terminal voltage of the battery when the circuit is closed.
So, for doing numericals, in one of the videos of current electricity, I have given to you some formulas.
So, let us go for the formula. Before that, I draw a circuit. Let us take a cell having EMF E, internal resistance is small r, and the external resistance that is connected is capital R. The formula for current is E by R plus R. The formula for terminal voltage is V equal to IR. Okay,
for the two parts given in the numerical, these two are the two formulas.
First one is I equal to E by R plus R. According to the circuit, plus first take the data given. EMF is 10 volt, small r is 3 ohm, capital R is not given, current is 0.5 ampere. Children, this is the data given to us. So, in this data, first I take the formula I equal to E by R plus R. What is the value of I? 0.5. Is equal to E by what is E? 10. Capital R not given, small r is negative. So 0.5 means I can take it as 1 by 2. I can take it as 1 by 2 children. R else, I can do one thing. R plus 3 equal to 10 by 0.5. 10 by 0.5 means 100 by 5, which is equal to 20. So R equal to 20 minus 3, how much it will be? 17 ohms.
I hope you have understood. The value of external resistance is obtained as 17 ohms. Now we go for the terminal potential difference. Now terminal potential difference V equal to the formula is I R. What is the value of current given? 0.5 into resistance is 17. You will get 8.5 volt. What you will get? You will get 8.5 volt. I hope you have understood, children. Next we go for third numerical. The third numerical is there are three resistors.
Three resistors, 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm are connected in series. What is the total resistance of the combination? Very simple. In series combination, the effective resistance will be sum of the three resistances. Therefore, for the first part, the effective resistance will be the formula is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Just add that 1 plus 2 plus 3, you will get 6 ohms. Here, number 2, second part. For doing the second part, I should draw the circuit diagram. I draw the circuit diagram like this. Before that, I read the question. If this combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volt, so take a battery of EMF 12 volt and of negligible internal resistance, so this battery has no internal resistance, so there will not be any drop across the internal resistance as it is zero. Obtain the PV across each resistance. Suppose this is R1, this is R2, this is R3. What is the value of R1? 1. What is the value of R2? 2. R3 is 3 ohm. We all know that in series combination, same current goes. So just find the current. Current I equal to E by RS. S stands for series combination. What is the effective resistance in series combination? 6 ohm. What is the EMF? 12 volt. So you will get 12 by 6, 2 ampere. Right. So, what is the current in the circuit? That is 2 ampere. Same 2 ampere current flows through 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm. 2 ampere, 2 ampere, 2 ampere. Now tell me, what is the potential drop across R1? P equal to IR. I into R1. What is the value of I here? 2 ampere. What is R1? 1 ohm. So, 2 into 1. 2 volt, V2, 2 into 2, how much it is? 4 volt, V3, 2 into 3, this is 6 volt. See that the sum of these 3 drops will be equal to 12 volt.
So this is the numerical number 3. So numerical number 3.1, 3.2 and 3.3. So today I have discussed these three numericals. In the next video, I'll discuss another three numericals. Like that, in 4 videos, we will finish all the numerical part. I hope you have understood, children. Thank you very much.